I got something in the mail from a fellow YouTuber. Guys, let's hope this isn't a bomb. The purpose of government. You know, I don't know if there really is a purpose of government. Because a government, to me, is just an organization that forces people to give it money. It basically says, give me money so I can provide services to you. But the services that governments provide aren't being provided any more effectively or efficiently than the individuals could have provided for themselves. So, I mean, essentially the government helps itself more than anybody else. So I don't think there's really an absolute need for a government at all. Now, people say that, you know, without government, there would be anarchy and, you know, there would be, you know, I'm not sure anarchy would be any worse than government-sponsored killing, you know. You still have killing, you just have different people doing it. Instead of the individuals deciding who dies, you'll have, instead of having the state decide who dies, you'll have the individuals deciding who dies. So I'm not sure it's really a better scenario for people overall. Anyway, government, what type of government would I like to see? I like to see a government stick to the basis of their actual purpose, or at least the purpose that they once served, to basically defend the people. Defend the people from external and internal threats. And I'm not talking about provide massive entitlements like Social Security and Medicaid and Medicare and unemployment, you know. I'm a big guy. I mean, I would feel more comfortable in a society where the government was a lot smaller but more effective. So there seems to be some confusion about how I feel about things. I would never want Social Security and Medicaid and Medicare and government and intervention and healthcare in the type of society that I would choose to live in. The problem with Social Security and a lot of these entitlement programs is that they're essentially Ponzi schemes. They're relying on the later payers, the later generations, to pay for the current generations because they spend most of the money in other areas. So by definition, it's working like a Ponzi scheme. The reason why I think the government should try to pay for Social Security and at least try to fulfill unemployment benefits for as long as it can is because the government owes it to the people to at least try to fulfill its obligations. If it were up to me, the only entitlement program we would have would be in education, and that would be for poor people going into science and math, and really anybody going into science and math. Those really scientific fields, useful fields, money fields, to be frank with you. I don't like the idea of an income tax. I think it's kind of stupid to penalize people for being productive. However, if you're going to have an income tax, why not make it as fair as possible? Why don't you just have a flat tax? Somebody said they want to see a progressive tax of 0 to 80%. Want to tax the most wealthy people, well, the wealthiest people at 80%. Well, that's stupid because you create a scenario where you're penalizing people for being productive. And you don't want to penalize people, the most productive people in your society. It's just flat out stupid. It discourages them from getting involved in innovation and really progressing the society. So I think we should have like a really low flat tax of about, I'll say 10, maybe 15% if we're going to have an income tax. Personally, you know, a lot of people consider me to be radical, but I would come up with a taxing situation where there wouldn't be any property taxes, any income taxes, and there would be one sales tax, 10%. The 5% of everything you buy will go to the federal government, and the other 5% will go to the state and the local. And that's all your taxes right there. And the government will be focused on defense, justice, security, that type of government. It wouldn't be, you know, we got a program for every freaking thing that you could think of type of situation. It's just that since we're in America and since the government has already made promises, I think it should at least honor their promises. Hey, let me explain to you guys what I mean about the whole Bunnings situation, about the whole cutting off unemployment. A lot of people say that, you know, unemployment is a bad idea to begin with. Okay, but here's the thing. Spending money on wars and corporate bailouts and then telling people, oh, we don't have enough money for unemployment, will be like me taking my credit cards going to Best Buy, buying 5 big screen TVs, buying a state-of-the-art audio system, then going to a strip club, spending $500, then getting a prostitute, then wasting more money at a bar, and then coming home, passing out, waking up the next day, and the mother of my child calls me and says, well, LaToya has to go to the dentist, so I need $100. And then I say, baby, I'm on a tight budget. You know, I think anarchy gets a really bad name because I think people have been programmed by the government to think that anarchy means Mad Max. It means, you know, the world coming to the end. I mean, that's part of government programming, basically. Without us, you are nothing, and the world will come to an end. Well, you know, here's the thing about anarchy. With governments, you have organizations deciding who gets killed. With anarchy, you have individuals. And the reason why the individuals are better qualified to decide who dies is because at the individual level, if you kill somebody, you'll have to deal with the consequences directly. Whereas with the government, you can make decisions to kill people without being directly affected by it. You can have somebody drop a bomb on somebody and not really be affected by that. When you have anarchy, you're sort of forced into a situation where you have to deal with the consequences immediately. Almost immediately. You have to worry about somebody, their family members coming back and trying to kill you. So with anarchy, I think you have less violence. The only time you really have a lot of violence with anarchy is when people are so dependent on the government that once the government goes away, people don't know how to exist without it. Well, I mean, that's sort of like a drug addict. You know, I mean, just because somebody stops using drugs and they're detoxing and they're really sick, that doesn't mean that it's healthy for them to start using the drugs again, you know? And that's pretty much what governments try to convince people. That, oh, you haven't had your medicine. You haven't had your medicine. So, you know, without your medicine, you'll be sick. Well, you know, the medicine is making people sick. It's the government that's making people sick. So, I think anarchy gets a really bad name. I think with anarchy, when you take away the bureaucracies, you have people interacting on a more personal level. And you're able to get more accomplished that way. You also have decentralization of power, which is really important. You're less likely to have a situation where there's only a handful of people making the decisions. And a lot of people who argue against anarchy say that, well, eventually anarchy becomes some type of dictatorship because people seek power. Well, you know, you can argue that. That's like arguing that you shouldn't try to get clean because you can eventually end up taking drugs again. Well, I mean, that's silly. You know, you shouldn't avoid detoxing because you're worried you might get hooked again. I mean, that's stupid. You know, I also think it's funny how governments create problems. People panic and they look for somebody to solve the problem, and then the government steps in. You know, it's like I said before. It's like a firefighter who's an arsonist. You know, the guy sets the fire, but then he's there to put it out. And you're thinking the guy for putting the fire out when he's the guy who started the fire to begin with. So I think that's what governments essentially do. They start the fire, then they find the most inefficient way to put the fire out. And everybody's like, oh, thank God the government was here. You know? So what do you think? Do we need government? And if we do need government, what is the purpose of government? What should government do? Should government provide universal health care? Should government provide social security? Or should people learn to save their own damn money? Because it sounds like that's what social security is, basically. Other than a Ponzi scheme, the idea is that, you know, I don't have enough control to save my own money, you know? So I need the government to save it for me and manage it for me. Should government just be security oriented? I don't know. You tell me what you think. Rate the video, comment, have a good day, bye. I got something in the mail from a fellow YouTuber. Guys, let's hope this isn't a bomb. Just playing with you. See, this little thing is working out already. Useful. For closing boxes. Alright. Let's see what it is. Dude, there's paper in here. What else is in here? Oh my god. It's a stove. This is from Centerville. What the hell is back here? Oh, he just has it well insulated. Well, that's thoughtful. This is a stove for my bug out bag. Man, as soon as I read the instructions, I'll figure out how to use it. But thank you, Centerville. It's going to be very useful.